Like the first time the female cast from Dead or Alive hit the beach, Dead or Alive Extreme 2 is like a gift to the fans of DOA fighting games, and anyone who enjoys looking at digital TNA. After being lured to an island resort by a scheming pervert named Zach, the girls find themselves with nothing to do but enjoy a bit of vacay. Volleyball, jet skiing, and pool sports await, and players will have plenty of opportunities to oogle the girls in motion. Maybe even perpetual motion. If only they could invent chewing gum that lasts that long. It's a tempting invitation for players looking for a bit of eye candy, but is there some hidden catch they didn't mention on the brochure? I wanna sing hallelujah. Although there's a lavish opening movie depicting the resurrection of Zack Island, and each girl has been given a phony baloney reason they should travel there. Sorry, Kasumi, your long-lost amnesiac brother really isn't here. Here's the real story of Extreme 2. There are a lot of pretty girls on the island. Look at the pretty girls. Before you start, you'll have to choose from one of 9 ladies to focus on. You'll be able to team up with another girl too, so you'll have a second pair of hands to help you out during volleyball. The girls are all quite lovely with their voluptuous figures and anime-esque charms, and if you've played a Dead or Alive game, you probably already have a favorite. Kasumi has that innocent look, and really large breasts. Tina is a Texas girl with a rebel disposition, and really large breasts. Christy is a cold, calculating assassin with an icy demeanor, and you get the picture. The game caters to certain tastes, but the girls really do have varied personalities that come through in the game. There are a number of different activities to check out. Jet skiing and volleyball are definitely the main events, but you're free to spend your time on other diversions. You've got pool hopping, tug of war, beach flags, a water slide, and the epically named butt battle. May the better butt win. When the sun goes down, you can spend time in the casino playing games like 5-card draw, blackjack, roulette, and slots. There's no Texas Hold'em, which seems like it would have been a no-brainer, but compulsive gamblers should be fairly happy with the selection. You can make some serious dough here, but if you play with high stakes, you could find yourself flat broke. One of the few times the word flat will come up when talking about a Dead or Alive game. You'll definitely need the money. There are a lot of different swimsuits to try on, over 300 total, and the skimpier they are, the bigger the price tag. There are a ton of accessories too, hats, sunglasses, sandals, hair ribbons, you name it. Shopping is a huge part of the experience. Besides filling out your character's wardrobe, you can buy items to use, like suntan lotion, or purchase different volleyballs and an armada of different jet skis to race in the marina. Dead or Alive Extreme 2 is a bit heavy on the visuals and light on the gameplay. But for the most part, the simple controls get the job done. Volleyball really only uses 2 buttons to play and is easy to get the hang of. Jet skiing seems to be modeled on another popular jet ski game and uses a pretty complicated control scheme involving buttons, sticks, and triggers. The other games tend to be very simple, using face buttons or the left analog stick exclusively. Winning at beach flags is as simple as mashing the heck out of a single button and then mashing a second button to leap for the flag at the last second. Surprisingly, you'll be doing a lot of work while the girls are on vacation. You'll have the morning, afternoon, and evening to pick an activity and bank some cash. It can take a lot of repetition to build up enough money to buy that barely there swimsuit, gain the gift-wrapped goods to woo a potential partner, or accomplish just about anything. Again, further highlighting the game's focus, volleyball and jet skiing are the most lucrative options. Performing well in any activity will make you some money, so if you think you're God's gift to butt battling, you have the freedom to pursue your dream. In DOA X2, there's playing the game, and then there's playing the game. If you're not feeling up to the competitive beach activities, you can choose the relax option, leaving you free to play cameraman and put the camera exactly where you want it, with some limitations. You'll probably feel weird if someone catches you in the act of digital voyeurism, but it's still disappointing that you only have an extremely short time to look at the girls before the screen goes black and you're back at the menu. You can get around this if you put in enough playtime, but if you really want to perv out, which is probably one of the few reasons to pick up this game, you'll have to sink in an obscene amount of time into it first.
I did it!
Speaking of menus, it's disappointing how much of the game feels like a dull computer program. Back in your hotel room, you'll be reading text, and looking at tiny portraits instead of gazing upon the graceful curves of a fully rendered busty babe. And every location on the island is like an isolated movie set you choose by shuffling through pictures. Extreme 2 is an extreme example of a game that doesn't really care about anyone's expectations other than the series fans. Think of it as a way to spend some personal time with the girls from the fighting game. If that doesn't interest you, and if you don't have a thing for well-endowed video game chicks, you're probably out of luck. There are some improvements over the first game, English voices for the girls.
Let me stay here just a bit longer.
The way each character's personality comes out in her poker strategy, and more stuff to do in general. The game isn't necessarily bad, but if you're not bringing your own fantasies to the table, you'll probably want to spend your vacation somewhere else.